Hey guys, JC6 here. Back with you with Phoenix Wright Trials and Tribulations. This is case number 3. We're moving closer to the end. Illegitimate means. That's crazy. Murder Glenn Elgin then made his next move. Friend Mackie Burke for the crime. And the Tiger posts Glenn Elk. While Viola Cadaverini played the role of Miss Bird. And they reignited the whole thing in order to establish a witness. The witness being the one who we all heard testify yesterday, Mr. Victor Kudo. Like I said, Trey, that's crazy. No one could pull off a stunt like that. Stars, there's no way the chef could have been kept out of it. But Mr. Armstrong knew all about it. He's gone already, Mr. Gatto. Mr. Armstrong owed the witness $500,000, in fact. He had no choice but to go along with Mr. Tiger's plan. We got everybody talking now. Core, ha ha ha. He's put on a good show, Spikey. If you just want to stay alive in the Lone Shark business, you gotta be careful. You say I dressed up like that kid, created a witness, and framed someone? I did something crazy like that, leave a trail as bright as my shirt. I ain't dumb enough to do something sloppy like that. I agree. What? Despite your appearance, you are very careful. That's why you took one more precaution. One more trick to make sure Miss Burr had no way out. What, another one, Mr. Wright? Interesting, why don't you fill us all in, Trite? What was the trick you say Mr. Tiger performed to friend the accused? Huh, that's a pretty big life bar. I mean, that's a pretty big penalty. What? And what's the relevance of that, right? It's just a little intro. Intro into what? Seems like this has been an elaborate trick on the part of the defense. Oh, dang! Well, let me save the game here. I don't want to... Yeah, I'll save the game right here. Thank you. What's this trick you say the tiger performed to frame the accused? Wait, is this it? I get the trick. Oh, what earth is that? I wouldn't start to think anyone could be fooled by such a childish imitation. Consider yourself insulted, Your Honor. Tiger, you didn't just pose as the victim of the day in question. A month ago in this very court, you posed as me. What? That's the truth. But the witness looks nothing like you, Mr. Wright. Although, now that I think about it, it was you, wasn't it? No doubt it was you standing in here at this very court a mere month ago. Being where I put on the most disreputable, shabby defense I've ever seen. Can you prove that, Grams? Prove the attorney who presented the accused here a month ago was this man? Are you prepared to take the stand and testify that it was him? Hey, forget about it, yeah? I wouldn't do something like that, not me. You made a mistake, right? It was someone else, huh? Have you no pride, sir? Right, let me close the door. This is a matter of pride. In case you didn't know, try here in court we deal with people's lives. Mr. Gall is right, Your Honor. Speaking for myself, I am absolutely convinced. The attorney question was the witness standing before me. However, I sat with this court as a judge with the vested power to hand down a verdict. So my position can't be swayed by memory without evidence to support it. No! And the defense has no further evidence. The court will now excuse the witness. Circumstances surrounding Mr. Tiger are dubious for sure, but not conclusive. We've come so far. You say you impersonate Glen Eld? They impersonated you? None of that adds up to a murder charge. And I have stripped evidence that the witness poisoned the victim's coffee. Ha! Huh. Sucks to be you, right? Mr. Tiger, you're gonna get mauled. You got that? All we managed to do here was chase him around a bit. So close to giving to admit his own guilt. Ha! It's like I won't be needing a refill. With just one more piece of evidence. One more piece of evidence, maybe I could get Maggie off the hook. When this cross-examination is over, you're free to go, Mr. Tiger. Your Honor, sir. Wait. Detective. Detective Gumshoe, sorry it took so long, pal. I staked everything on this. My badge, the worst. Here it is. My heart's counting on this, too. What is it, Detective? The obvious, pal, is to find a decisive piece of evidence. What? Oh, January 8, 2:48 p.m. It's your court. So it took so long, pal, but I finally got the results from the lab. So it's about the prince, pal, from his medicine bottle. So do you know who the prince belonged to now? I think I'm some kind of hack detective, of course I know. So tell us. The tiger's right, I knew it. Heh. You bet. Put his crystal all over the bottle. Your favorite tiger's paw prints, alright? It's good, we've got him now, Nick. What's wrong with you? You've hardly said a word since Detective Gumshoe got here. It's like everything on the line for us, Nick. I know, look, I'm sorry, this is kind of hard to say, but this really doesn't make any difference, prints are on that bottle now. And what? Why not? What we need to produce at this stage in the trial? Irrefutable evidence that the tiger put poison in Glenn Ellis' coffee. So already admitted that he met the victim. But his prints are on his bottle. That really doesn't make any difference now. I knew it. Great. No matter how hard I try, I'm never of any use. Well, you made those good sausages, Gumshoe. Hey, don't be so hard on yourself. This was our last chance to help Maggie. I've been working on some useless piece of evidence the whole time. It's alright, I'm a real loser. It's not breaking news to me, pal. Well, you didn't get the detective by being a loser, right? Not anyone can be a detective, right? Detective Gumshoe? Maggie? You've been working on something for me? So I let you down, Maggie. I know you didn't do it. I'm a detective. We're supposed to be able to prove stuff like that. I'm really sorry to get out of your hair now. Detective Gumshoe, wait. He's gone. Is there something we can do now, Nick? Wish there was. Gumshoe worked so hard to get the evidence. If only there was some way I could use it. Right, yes, Your Honor. I granted you a recess so you could prepare the decisive evidence you've discovered. Yes. Don't keep us all in suspense, try to show us. Naturally, we can assume it's evidence that we actually stand up in court, can't we? Think, Phoenix. Don't let Gumshoe's hard work go to waste. How much more of my time are you going to waste? I ain't been to no court before. But these lawyers sure know how to blow things out of proportion. No doubt given the nature of the evidence, it will speak for itself. Nevertheless, you will talk us through it, Mr. Wright. I know I can't prove anything new with this evidence. I'm really backed into a corner, but maybe if he thinks he's got me beat. So let's go down a bit. Don't keep us waiting any longer, Mr. Wright. Present this final decisive piece of evidence to the court. This is the defense's final piece of evidence. Isn't that the victim's? Your Honor, Naturally, the quartz already aware of the contents of this bottle. However, interesting new information has come to light. It clearly identifies some fingerprints on it. Fingerprints belonging to you, Mr. Tiger. What? Well, Mr. Wright, what conclusion are you hoping to draw from this new information? Everyone here knows what the bottle contains. Except one man, one person in this quorum should theoretically be in the dark. The print on that pansy looking bottle? Is that what you're saying? What the hell's in it anyway? Phony trial, phony lawyer, and phony clues? Anything about this case has been phony. Sounds like the perfect excuse for some phony evidence. Well, I'll stop right here. Take care, everybody. I'll see you guys next time.